Hi, I'm Nina von Pessler, and today I'm going to show you how to add the SNMP Nutanix Cluster Health and the SNMP Nutanix Hypervisor Sensor. Before getting started with setting up the two Nutanix sensors, I just wanted to mention beforehand that for this to work, you have to have SNMP enabled on your Nutanix. And if you're unsure how to do this, we're going to link the how-to below this video. Another thing you can do beforehand is test if the SNMP is working properly. For this, we'll link the link to Pessler's SNMP tester below as well. Good, then we are ready to start. As you can see, I'm already in my PRTG installation. And now I just have to navigate to the device tree and find the Nutanix device I want to use, which is this one here. And I'll just say add sensor. Since we're going to use SNMP today, or both sensors are SNMP, I'm just going to use the toggle here that says SNMP. And I'm going to say search for Nutanix. The first one I want to show you is the Cluster Health sensor. As you can see, the setup is pretty straightforward. I just wanted to mention that make sure if you have more options available in measurement, that you select exactly the one you want, because you cannot change this later on. If you need or want to change it, you would have to re-add the sensor. Good, with that being said, I'm just gonna say create the sensor. And I'll scroll down to look for my sensor. For now, there has not been any data pulled, so I'm going to speed it up by saying scan now, and you can see that the channels are coming in. Okay, my sensor is up and running, everything is green, and as you can see, the sensor gives me a general status overview and also an overview over the in and output of my bandwidth, latency, and operations. So let's go back to my Nutanix systems and show you how to add the other sensor. I'm going to click on the little blue plus here. Again, I'm going to say SNMP and search for Nutanix. And this time I'm going to select the hypervisor sensor. So again, I only have one option with the measurement. As said before, make sure if you have more that you select the one you want and need. And you'll now see that the greatest difference between those two sensors is actually their channels. I'll show you this by looking for my sensor and forcing it to scan now. Okay. Here you can see I get different channels to the sensor before. I can now also see the CPU usage, the VM count, the dropout and drop-in of packets, stuff like that.
If you find this video helpful, feel free to like it and consider watching our other videos on our channel. If you still have questions, please contact support@pessler.com, and always feel free to comment for feedback or suggestions for other topics. Thank you.